generally on Twitter.
Sure.
Follow me. And so Jeff and I started a conversation. Jeff is with a company called Rightpoint out of the Chicago area. Out of Chicago, I guess, proper.
Sure.
Downtown Chicago. And we had a conversation at the just after the SharePoint Saturday Chicago Suburbs event. We were talking about the need or the growing influence of social influence in the enterprise. And whether that's something, whether it's a real thing that's growing or not, there are organizations like Clout, and I'm sure like you can go in and look at your Clout score, and we've had conversations about this. What are you seeing in your practice and people's interest in being able to track and measure and be able to even manipulate influence scores and utilize that within the enterprise?
So I believe that, thanks for having me, Chris.
Yeah.
I believe that this whole idea of social influence goes back to what's in it for me as an influencer. So I equate that if I'm going to be influential within an organization, what does that mean to me and what good is it going to do me? For one, when I think about that, I think it's job security for me. Number two is I want to disseminate a message within the organization. Being an influencer, people are going to listen to what I'm going to say. At the end of the day, everyone wants to be heard.
Right. Well, I mean, a key part of that is you cannot, it's difficult to go and to prove the case that you are an influencer on a topic if there's not a way to measure that. And I think one of the chief complaints of platforms like Clout and Cred and Peer Index and some of the others that are popping up now is that we don't have a lot of insight into the algorithms behind it. What is actually going into the building and the measurements of these things? Like, how do you do that inside of an enterprise?
For me, if I'm posting something on our intranet or portal and people are commenting on it, they're liking it, and there's interaction, case closed, right?
Well, to some degree, I mean, you can look at kind of the usage analytics. I mean, obviously, if you have someone who's posting regularly, I always like to kind of give the generic examples of, two individuals posting content, same amount of volume. One of them gets a lot of comments, the other one gets no comments.
But that's a no-brainer, right?
But some organizations want, if you think of, let's look at the depth of what Clout attempts to do, was it's not just looking at the number of tweets, the number of blog posts, the volume of that activity, but the depth of that activity, like how people who receive those messages relay that, retweet it, push it out there, and take action on those.
That's what it's all about. If you write a blog post, and I'm sure nothing gets you more excited to see 100 comments at the bottom, that's a huge win for you. To me, that's better than a retweet or anything that you could possibly, what else could you do that you could get 100 comments on? That's the best for me. To me, that's what social influence is all about. And you want a topic, say you're talking about SharePoint and engagement, and you write this article and you get 100 comments on it, positive or negative, and you're responding, that's,
You just said something like the word engagement. And I think that's more than anything what the influence score measures is the level of engagement an individual has with their network around them. But it can be within an enterprise difficult to measure because one of the discussions that's been going on within the community is around subject matter experts and whether these kinds of tools accurately capture their level of influence.
I don't know, I've got a Facebook page, a Jay Willey Facebook page. Not my personal one, I've got a business one. And I think you might have one too, I'm not sure. But I'm able to, if I post one of your blog posts on my Facebook page, I'm able to see how many people clicked on that. And of course, I'm able to see the comments. But I'm able to see on your Christian Buckley Facebook page, if you post something, you can't tell how many people are clicking on that. I think that's pretty powerful information.
It is.
I guess maybe I could even see who's clicking on it. I've never looked that deep into it, but I think that's pretty engaging.
But I think for people like us that are in the content that we create, whether it's internal or external, we are trying to look at those measurements and look at the impact of what we're doing. I mean, that's part of SEO. I mean, that's part of, it's that marketing, advertising perspective on that kind of content. But I think one of the, my impression is that, you know, talking with people within the community that are frustrated that discount the validity of tools like Clout and Cred are the fact that you might have somebody who is the typical engineer, who is the expert on a topic, but is not out front in the company, not a marketer, not, you know, out there evangelizing. And yet when they speak, you know, everyone listens to their advice. They are the
social, right? They're just not that social. They're not that out there, but yet they are very influential. So how do we?
In the enterprise, I think that's the key difference.
Yeah.
When you're talking to the consumer, like out in the field, I mean, it's all about the social aspects, but enterprise.
A best practice within organizations that I'm seeing out there, Christian, is identifying these users and then tagging them. So for me, as a best practice in an organization, I want to say, find someone that knows a lot about insurance. I'm going to type in insurance in the search. I want to see, and what comes back is the people that authored it, the people that are tagged as experts in that, and the articles that they might have written or documents that are attached to that. I think that that's powerful within an organization, being a culture of collaboration and a culture of knowledge sharing.
So that should be, I mean, it sounds like what you're saying is that, you know, part of the role of the organization should do is should be surfacing who those SMEs are,
yes.
Whether they're unable to or unwilling, they're just not knowledgeable.
They have to be tagged up front.
Right.
They have to be, when you know, through Active Directory, I know, you know, ask me about Photoshop, ask me about Illustrator, ask me about SharePoint. These people have to be tagged up front, and then so you've got company designated tags, and then you, Christian, say you're into sailing, you could have a Christian-based tag. So when people are trying to find someone, or say more on a social level, they want to find out sailors in the organization,
right.
They might find you.
Not sailing, but
okay.
Me, but yeah.
I was gonna say bowling, but sailing was a little sexy.
I bowled, yeah, okay. Okay, right. But it does sound like that is an important factor within the enterprise is like the, you know, helping those individuals and surface that information. It's almost like you need an information architect for influence, somebody that's going out there doing the SO on your SEO on the community to be able to surface that information, because it certainly doesn't happen on its own. This idea that when we have these tools and these measurements and then we just let it loose, you know, not any offense to people like us that are evangelist marketing people, where we'll automatically, you know, show up in those numbers because of just the way that we do our day-to-day activities, but making sure that the people that are those subject matter experts that are also rising up within that, you know, because of the content and resources they have.
Absolutely, especially in global organizations, I think that's key for them to be, again, known as these, you know, what I'm seeing a lot of, cultures of knowledge sharing and cultures of collaboration. Having that embedded into their culture are really what's going to separate the average organizations to the world-class organizations.
You know, as we wrap up here, I mean, there was a comment that was made back, a good friend of ours, so Seth Matthews, was talking about the need for a classification of the type of influencers, so that you even can flag those people that are like the developer, the subject matter expertise, you know, the SMEs, versus those that are the product or the marketing side or the evangelist side of things, so that it almost weights the level of activity a little bit different, so that when I go into a search for an expert and I might find your profile or my profile, it might be different. I always use, like, you know, Bill Baer as being one of my favorite SMEs in the SharePoint platform. You know, Bill doesn't do the level of, out in the community, the level of promotion,
sure,
around, you know, himself and the brands and things and the way that
he's very influential, though. Right, he's
never
of these things.
Right. But, you know, so that when you're searching for those results, that you have your SMEs that are showing up almost, you know, in parallel with, you know, the product and the marketing folks around that.
I mean, this dates back, Christian, to the days, well, they're still very influential, the mommy bloggers of the world, that if Whirlpool is going to give me a new washer or dryer, that I'm going to blog about it. And it's known up front that they're getting this for free in exchange for writing a favorable review of it. You know, they're influencing. If I see that you're not a mommy blogger, but if you know someone that is, no, you don't play one on TV either. Seeing that you're buying a Whirlpool, you're getting a Whirlpool washer or dryer, and I'm like, wow, if Christian has got it, it looks good to me. Because that whole idea of peer-to-peer recommendations, I think that's why that Bing search is so powerful. They take that data from Facebook, your trusted friends, and that rise to the top. So if I'm looking for a hotel in Washington, D.C., and I see that Christian or Naomi stayed there and gave it thumbs up, I am going to take that over any TripAdvisor. That's influence.
Well, it's interesting. I think it's an interesting space. There's a lot that's going on. I think there's a number of companies that are on the consumer space that are looking more at the enterprise space. I think we're going to see some very creative solutions coming out of that, and we're going to be talking a lot more about this topic. Because I know we've talked about this, and you agree that the social influence is a core part of social collaboration and the growing influence of social collaboration within the enterprise.
So Christian, we could talk for hours.
I know we can.
But I know if you're like me, your attention span is 140 characters.
Do you want to check out anything written by Jeff Willinger at Rightpoint Consulting?
Actually, it's just rightpoint.com, Jay Willy on Twitter.
Even easier.
I actually even have a blog, Jay Willinger, on Tumblr. And
I'll put you'll see it like at the bottom of the video and stuff here. So cool. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Christian.
Thank you.